Let's see what rule number 7 states. Rule number 7, it states if one of these words like each, every, no, or none are used before the subject, verb will be, verb is singular. Okay, so our rule number 7, what it says, if one of these words like each, every, no, or none. Children, each, every, no, or none, these are our quantifiers. Okay, हम इन्हें quantifiers के क्लास में पढ़ते हैं as determiners. Each, every, no, or none. और simple words में देखें तो ये हमारे adverb of, adjective of number है, indefinite. Okay, fine. So, if one of these words, each, every, no, or none are used before your subject, आपका verb क्या होगा? Singular. For example, let's see. Let's see this example. Every man and woman is required to check in. Okay, so what we have used? In our subject, we are having two subjects, man and woman. But because we have used this quantifier every, okay, so every man and woman is required to check in. So here our verb is in which form? Plural form. Singular form. Okay, and this is what our rule number 7 says, okay, if we are using such sort of words. Let's look at the rule number 8. What does rule number 8 it says? If we are using compound connectors or compound conjunctions, okay, along with our singular subjects, then again our verb will be singular. Okay, if we are using compound connectors, okay, compound connectors or conjunctions like either or, neither nor, not only but also, it also, this rule also applies to words like or, nor. So when we are using these words, when we are using all these words like either or, neither nor, not only but also, or nor, okay, with what? Singular subjects, our verb will be singular. Let's see the illustration. Okay, let's take one example first. Either Jessica or Annie is to blame for mishap. Now, some children, what they assume, that this entire is a, you know, more than one subject, so it is a plural form of subject, and they write are, which is incorrect. Okay, either or, it gives us a choice. Okay, so hence we have to use the singular form of the verb. Either Jessica or Annie is to blame for mishap. Okay, similarly, if we want to weave a sentence with neither nor, supposed to move out. Okay, so again here we can see we are having two subjects, but neither nor, again it gives a choice. So our verb will be in which form, children? It will be in singular form. If you write it as ki either Jessica or Annie are to blame for mishap, then it is incorrect. Okay, so our rule number 7 says that compound connectors like either or, neither or, but not only but also, even words like or, nor, they are not in the category of compound connectors. These are not compound connectors. Or, nor, and singular subjects are used, then the verb will be singular. Okay, fine. So this is your rule number 7. Let's discuss rule number 8. Rule number 8, I find it very interesting, and I believe you people will also find it soon. Now, in rule number 8, it says that verb will be singular. Okay, verb will be singular if we are referring to, let's see, this is rule number 9, sorry, either or one was 8. Rule number 9, it says verb is singular when we are referring to distances, periods of time, and sum of money. Okay, verb is always singular if distances, period of time, and sum of money, we are referring to them as what? We are referring to them as subject of the sentence. Okay, as well as these distances, period of time, sum of money, they are working as subject, as well as they are what? They are the unit. They are assumed as unit. To measure a quantity. Okay, hum kisi unit means to measure a certain quantity, we use distances, period of time, sum of money. Ise hum subject ki place mein rakhte hain. फिर भी हमारा वर्ब सिंगुलर होगा. हाउ? थ्री माइल्स हियर इज व्हाट? इट्स अ यूनिट ऑफ, हियर वी हैव मेजर्ड द डिस्टेंस बाय सेइंग थ्री माइल्स. And see the subject verb, we have used a singular verb. We have used here a singular verb. Do not go look into this ki 3 miles. Miles, because it is showing more than one. Okay, so it is plural. So our verb will be plural? No. Agar aap is rule ko apply karenge, to aapka sentence incorrect ho jayega. You have to apply rule number 9, that verb is singular with distances, period of time, sum of money, when they are used as subject and are assumed as unit, and they are assumed as unit, that means measurement ke hisab se hum use kar rahe hain. Say for example, period of time ko agar hum lete hain, to iski ye ho gaya 5 years, is the maximum sentence for that offense. Okay, so here again, 5 years is what? It is just a unit, measurement of unit we have done, and it is our, or ye consider kya hoga as a singular subject. Hum ise singular subject hi manenge, because it is a unit here, and this is सिंगुलर वर्ब, हम इससे मेजर कर रहे हैं टाइम पीरियड को, टाइम पीरियड फॉर अ गिवन सेंटेंस, किसी पनिशमेंट के लिए ये जो है टाइम पीरियड फिक्स किया गया है. एंड अगेन फॉर सम ऑफ मनी, लेट्स टेक फॉर एग्जांपल, 10 pounds इज अ ह्यूज अमाउंट टू पे. Okay, so again here 10 pounds is what? A singular subject, but it is functioning here as a unit of where we are measuring money. Okay, and this is our singular verb. Okay, it is again our singular verb. So children, rule number 9, it states that a verb is singular if we are referring to distances, period of time and sum of money as subject. Okay. And here as subject, they are assumed as a unit, that is measurement of a certain quantity. Then we use our rule number 9. Let's move on to rule number. So in our rule number 10, children, we are going to refer to the words which indicate a portion of a certain quantity or certain number of persons. Okay. So when we are referring words that indicate words that indicate portion of certain object, or we can also here say person, or it refers to the quantity. Okay. Quantity of certain object or person. Now in this rule number, children, what happens? We have to be very particular because we are going to deal with words like a lot of, a majority of, some of, all of, etc. Okay, so we are going to refer to these words as a portion or quantity of certain object, or when if we are referring to some person. A lot of, person it will be like a majority of people casted their vote, okay, in that form. So a lot of, a majority of, some of, all of, etc. When we are dealing with these words which indicate a portion of a quantity, how will our verb will be? Our verb depends upon the number of the, again, what? Noun. Okay? The noun which will be placed certainly after of. Okay? Fine. So in these cases, again, if noun after of is singular, verb is singular and vice versa. Okay, fine children. So if noun after of, this of, okay, after of is singular, verb is singular and the vice versa, that means if the noun after of is plural, the verb will be plural. Okay, let's take for example, a lot of the pie has disappeared again, the same illustration but in the plural form. A lot of the pies have disappeared. Okay, now children, quickly look. A lot of, it is indicating what? A portion, a quantity of what? A pie. It can be your chocolate pie whatsoever. A lot of pie, the pie has disappeared. So here, because it is in singular form, we have used singular form of the auxiliary has. Now, a lot of the pies have disappeared, because here our noun s. After of is in plural form, so we have used the plural form of the auxiliary have. Okay, so this is how our rule number 10, it says that if we are indicating to a certain portion and are using words like a lot of, a majority of, some of, all of, etc., we will be using our noun. And for that, before we have to see that our noun after of should be singular or plural. Singular hai to singular verb, plural hai to plural verb. So this is how our rule number 10 it functions. Now, I'll be discussing rule number 11 with you. What does rule number 11 says? Our rule number 11, it says that sometimes we use verb. It is in specific cases only when we are referring to sentences of past tense. We use verb in case of to replace was we use verb to replace was if we are expressing a wish or a contrary fact. Okay, children, so here our rule number 11 says ki we use were to replace was if we are expressing a wish or a contrary fact. For example, if Joe were here, you had argued. Okay, fine. So here this is our sentence. If Joe were here, you would not have argued. Okay, so children, see here it is applying this rule number 11. Joe is what? Joe is a singular subject. Hum singular subject ke saath kya use karte hain? Was use karte hain. But here we have replaced was with what? Were. If Joe were here, you wouldn't had argued. And the second part of the sentence, you wouldn't had argued, is also filling our second situation, contrary fact. So if it is a wish, if we are expressing a wish, हम हमारी इच्छा भी व्यक्त कर रहे हैं और एक contrary fact भी है कि अगर जो यहाँ पे होता तो आप argue नहीं करते. तो if जो were here, और यहाँ पे हम was use नहीं करेंगे. अगर हम was use कर रहे हैं तो incorrect है. Generally what happens, we use was with singular subject. Okay, so it is one of the rare cases, but this rule, because it is vital, so you have to keep it in your mind. Okay, now let's discuss the last rule number, that is rule number 12, and with this we will wind up our topic, subject verb agreement concord. Okay, rule number 12 is very short to even for me to write and for you children to remember. And what it is, rule number 12 is parentheses are not a part of subject. Okay, our parentheses are not a part of subject. Children, parentheses in simple means brackets. Okay, Arnav and his friend is always welcome. Okay, so though here in parenthesis we have written more than one, but we are going to consider Arnav this as the subject of our sentence. So Arnav and his friend is always welcome. We will not be writing it as Arnav and his friends are always welcome. If we are writing here are, then our sentence will be incorrect. Okay, so here again parentheses are not, parentheses means brackets are not a part of subject. In such a case you have to use singular form of the verb. Okay, aur aapko is cases mein bhi singular form, humne yahan pe singular form isliye use kiya hai children again because my subject of this sentence is singular. If it would have been plural, okay, they and their friends are always welcome, hum yahan pe ek hamare third personal pronoun प्लूरल ले लेते हैं दे, और दे एंड देयर फ्रेंड्स आर ऑलवेज वेलकम, इन दैट केस वो आर हो जाता. बट यहाँ पे हमारा सब्जेक्ट क्या था, सब्जेक्ट ही प्लूरल है तो उसको मैच करने के लिए वी विल बी राइटिंग आर. ओके, बिकॉज हमारा रूल नंबर वन ही ये कहता है कि इफ आर सब्जेक्ट इज सिंगुलर द वर्ब विल बी सिंगुलर, इफ आर सब्जेक्ट इज प्लूरल द वर्ब विल बी प्लूरल. सो विद दिस चिल्ड्रेन आई हैव डिस्कस्ड विथ यू 12 वेरी वाइटल रूल्स ऑफ subject verb concord. Go through this video and read the rules thoroughly, which I will be posting you soon. Do take very good care of yourselves, children. God bless you all.